Hi, I am Joe Sam and I am from Technology Research Lab. In this tutorial, let's see how we can install Oracle JDK with the help of apt-get on Ubuntu. Let's keep the following command in a text editor so that we can copy-paste it while installing. The first command is required for adding Oracle's PPA. The second command will update your package repository. From command 3rd and 4th, you can install the version of Oracle JDK either 8 or 9. As there can be multiple Java installations on one server, you can select the right version to configure by using the command sudo update --alternative --config java. The rest of the command is used for setting up Java home environment variable. Now let's see an installation procedure of Oracle Java Development Kit. Let's get to the UI and open the terminal. Copy the first command, which is to add Oracle PPAs, and paste it on the terminal. It will ask for the password. Copy the second command, which is to upgrade or update your package repository. Copy it and paste it on the terminal. Now we have to install Oracle JDK version 8 or 9. Copy the third command and paste it on the terminal. Say OK to Oracle binary code license agreement and accept the license term. It might take 1 to 2 minutes. I will be installing Oracle JDK 8 and 9 so as to show you how to manage multiple Java installation. Copy the fourth command, which is to install Oracle JDK 9. After the completion of Oracle JDK 8 installation, paste the fourth command, which is to install Oracle JDK 9, to the terminal. It will then require few more minutes to complete. There can be multiple Java installation on one server. Use the fifth command to choose the alternative and configure the desired version as default. Now here the result shows Java 9 Oracle on auto mode, Java 8 and 9 on manual mode. You can select the alternative by entering the corresponding number. The next step is to set the Java home environment variable. To set this variable, we need to find out where Java is installed. We can find out by executing the same fifth command. Copy the path from your preferred installation and then execute the sixth command. At the end of this file, add the seventh line. You can now save and exit the file and reload it via 8th command. The last command, echo java home, tests whether the environment variable is been set or not. The command java-version will check the version which has been installed, and if it is the preferred version, then we are all set.